back to my channel. My name is Allison Clarke and I'm a senior portrait and wedding photographer based out of Southern New Hampshire. And I'm also an educator for those who are just starting their own photography, but I need to start over already. Hello friends and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Allison Clarke and I'm a senior portrait and wedding photographer based out of Southern New Hampshire. And I'm also an educator for those who are just starting their own photography businesses and want to learn a little bit more. This week, I'm answering a question that I've gotten a lot recently, which is, when you were first starting out, how did you know how to price your services? And I very much like this question because I think that it's super important. As somebody in their first year of business who way undercharged and did not understand pricing, to now having a full understanding of pricing and how to determine what is the best price to charge for your services. I think it's super important for everybody to learn this, whether you are in your first year or in your 10th year of business. Kind of always reevaluating your prices and your cost of doing business and kind of determining what you should be charging from there. So I wanted to give you guys kind of three simple tips to help you decide how much you should be pricing your services for. The first step to determining how to price your services is to look at your business expenses. So for me, some of these expenses might include camera equipment. They might include my CRM HoneyBook, which is about $400 a year. They might include Pixie Set, which is how I deliver my images, so that's a monthly cost. It might include my Lightroom and Photoshop subscriptions, which is a monthly cost. There's literally so many things. I invest in education, I invest in Blog Stomp and Photo Mechanic. So many different expenses that come with running a photography business. My show at site is a monthly cost. I could go on and on. So basically, the first step is to sit down and make a list of all of your business expenses, looking at how much you pay per month for each of these really services, and kind of finding a total for that on how much you pay per month to run your business. The second thing that you want to do is sit down in the next column, figure out what your personal expenses are. So this is maybe the rent for your apartment, how much you pay for groceries, your heating and water bills. If you wanted to decide that you wanted to be able to spend $100 a month on clothing, that would be in there. So these are things that For me, it would be coffee. I buy coffee every day from Dunkin's. So these are things that you spend money on personally, maybe things that you need to spend money on or things that you want to spend money on. Like I said, for me, that's coffee. So if I want to spend $3 a day at Dunkin's for 30 days a month, then that's $90 a month is my Dunkin's budget. So figure out your personal expenses, outline them all, how much it costs you per month to live as a normal human being. Don't forget also that you have things like your savings and your retirement. Those count as personal expenses. So if you wanted to be able to put, let's say, $100 a month into your retirement account, then you need to add that into your personal expenses. If you want to say you want to save 30% of your income and put that into a separate savings account, that needs to be in there. Taxes need to be in there. Insurance needs to be in there. So don't forget about any of those super important things too, not just the short-term things like coffee every morning, but also the long-term things like savings and retirement are super important to consider when you're outlining your personal expenses. The third thing that you need to examine now that you have your two columns laid out is your volume. So for me, that's how many sessions I can take on per month or how many weddings I can take on per month. I don't do more than one wedding in a weekend, so I can only take on a max of 4 weddings per month. For sessions, I like to do 2 to 3 senior sessions per week, preferably 2, but sometimes, you know, in busy season, things get a little bit different. So that's my volume. So that's the set amount of things that I can actually, the services that I can provide in 1 month. So for a videographer, maybe that does weddings, they can film up to 8 weddings per month. It totally depends on you, what your capabilities are as a human, how much back-end stuff there is. So for me, like editing takes a long time too. So I have to factor that in when I'm deciding how much volume I can take on. But once you have those two columns laid out of your expenses, then determine how much can I actually do. How many people can I serve in this 1 month? From there, the equation is super simple. So for example purposes, I'm going to keep these numbers super clean cut and easy, but just know that these do not reflect the actual business and personal expenses that the average human has, but I'm bad at math, so we're going to keep this easy for example purposes. So let's say, again, for easy number purposes, your business expenses are $500 a month and your personal expenses are $1,500 a month. And then you add those up and your total expenses are $2,000. And you decided earlier that you can only take on 10 sessions per month. So let's say you do seniors and you can only take on 10 seniors per month. From there, you can divide 2,000 by 10 and know that you have to charge at least $200 per session in order to make up for your expenses and be able to pay for both your business expenses, pay for your personal expenses, you know, and kind of still add into your savings and pay taxes and all that jazz. If you have any questions about this formula, again, I made it super easy for example purposes, but there's a lot that goes into this. So being able to sit down with a spreadsheet or a pen and paper and write all these things down is super important when you're first starting and you need to learn how to price your services. You shouldn't just be looking at other photographers' websites and kind of charging what they charge because they might have different expenses than you. Maybe their mortgage is higher or lower. Maybe they have less programs that they use, you know, really it's all different. So you should be doing it based off of your own life and your own expenses and how much it costs you to not only live but run your business. But like I said, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. I'd be more than happy to help. I'm not an accountant, but I can help as much as I possibly can. I'm willing. So definitely leave those questions in the comments below and leave a like if this video is helpful for you. Also, if you are a portrait photographer who has not yet downloaded my free guide, it is linked in the description below. It is called Posing with Confidence, 6 Tips to Help You Slay Your Next Senior Session. And it's all about not only leveling up your posing and therefore your client experience, but also helping your clients feel natural and comfortable and confident in front of your camera, which again, only levels up your client experience. So I could go on and on about the importance of posing, but I will let the guide do the talking. Again, it is linked in the description below. You don't want to miss out. If you don't already follow me on Instagram, my username is Allison Clarke Photography, super simple. Shoot me a follow on there as I give free tips on my stories and my feed on the daily. I also answer my DMs like all the time, so don't hesitate to reach out there as well. I'm more than happy to help with any questions that you have. Again, that is all I have for you guys today, but make sure to hop back over to my channel next Friday to see my new video, and I hope you all have a great weekend.